Gary, thank you so much for being here. We were talking about it's been 5 or 6 years, and it's nice to know you haven't just been sitting on your laurels all this time.
And that you are still here sharing some great information with people.
Well, thank you. When you were here before, we focused on two or three different areas of mm-hmm. your life, and you shared with us from the business standpoint and what was called, I thought it was cute, it was called Garyisms. But this book is on the power of get statements. And I had to read it again. I thought, now, did you use that word out of order? You know, I had to, and it's interesting because I don't think we realize how we talk sometimes and what those words, what we're wanting to say, but how they come out.
You know, it really is true. And the way the word get came up was, you know, many times we say we must do something or we have to do something. And I don't know if you're like me, but if you tell me I have to do something, normally I'm going to do the opposite. And not necessarily proud of that, but it's mm-hmm. something I just know about myself. But the word get, I was thinking about a word that could actually embrace that drawing towards something that was positive. Mm-hmm. And the word get came to my mind. And then I'm not satisfied just with the word. You have to have an acronym. And that acronym for the word get is Great Expectations Today.
Great Expectations Today. And I read, as I was reading through the book, your book, I thought it was so interesting. It said, get statement is a future result stated in the present tense.
Present tense with a date of accomplishment. Mm-hmm. But it's going into your future and making it so real that you can see it, taste it, and feel it. And bringing that vision back to your present day so that you're now being pulled towards that reality and you're not just having to go towards it. It's not something you get up in the morning and go, oh golly, I've got to do this to be able to do that. Mm-hmm. You get up in the morning and you are actually programming yourself and reminding yourself why you're doing what you're doing. And so it makes that trip worthwhile, even though at times we're having to do things that we may not like.
Mm-hmm. Or maybe hard for us because we're not used to it.
Correct.
Is this a bit of what some people call positive affirmations?
It is similar. Affirmations, I think, are good. I don't think they go far enough because an affirmation is just stating a positive statement, like I am wealthy or I am rich. And you look at your bank account and go, no, I'm not. And so a get statement is an actuality. It's a result in the future that allows us to embrace a new reality before it actually shows up in our physical sense, in our physical world. And so years ago, I wanted to receive a particular watch. And as I was embracing a get statement, what happened was I was actually seeing myself go into a particular jeweler and be able to have that watch. Now, I did get the watch, it's right here, but it wasn't even from that same jeweler. But that experience every day of having that real life experience, I call it creating your personal deja vu. And having that experience, in fact, I had that experience one day when I was, I love flying. You know, I like airplanes. And one day, Beach had called me and said, would you come up to the airport? We know you're busy. We'd like to preview an aircraft to you. And I went, oh, golly,
wow,
great.
How exciting.
And I called my best friend and said, you're now my VP of marketing. I told Sharon, you know, you get dolled up. We're going to go see this airplane. And we go up, and I said, how long are we going to, you know, have to look at the plane? And they go, well, it's up to you. It's in the air. And I'm going, oh, golly, this is great. And I get into the plane, and they go, would you like to fly right seat, which is the co-pilot? Uh-huh. And the thing that happened, though, is as we were coming onto the runway, I had visualized this so long that it was like that visualization and the present day came together.
Uh-huh.
And that really
joined.
I had prepared myself. Uh-huh. And it makes it a lot more fun than just saying, I'm going to accomplish X or I'm going to make so much money or whatever that goal may be.
So just setting a goal without any action following it does no good.
Well, it can, but it doesn't have the energy. So you'd be like, you're going to get there, but you're going to also have maybe that feeling of running in molasses so that you're not really
sluggish.
Getting that, yeah, you're not getting the full benefit of that energy that you're expending.
Mm-hmm. So do you think that's why a lot of us maybe resist putting it down, writing down what, you know, I want to lose 20 pounds, I want to lose this, I want to get $100,000. I thought that was an interesting story in here about the 100,000. Tell us about that.
You know, the 100,000 for a monetary, for people as far as receiving, whether you're a W-2 employee or a self-employed business owner, is really the same. And what happens is that $100,000 seems to be that glass ceiling. Once you hit that, then you're just duplicating. Mm-hmm. But mentally, we have built a ceiling for ourselves. And, you know, when we do that, we put that resistance in. But I think that there's another component, and that is we have taught ourselves not to dream. And that we used to, at the beginning of every year, we had a little ritual. What was it?
New Year's resolutions.
That's it. Mm. New Year's Eve resolutions.
I just quit those.
You know, and when I ask audiences, and it doesn't really matter how big it is, usually I only have one or two that still do it. And I ask people, why don't you do that anymore? Mm-hmm. And they go, why would I want to feel bad when on January 3, I'm already so far behind that I know that I can't catch up?
Mm-hmm.
And so we have taught ourselves not to dream, not to set goals, because we don't want to be disappointed.
Oh, uh-huh.
And we don't want to feel bad. Because we, particularly in North America, we have this game that we do called comparison.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to compare myself to you, and whether or not I'm up to speed, or are you ahead of me? And, you know, when we don't set the goal, now we can have that little more invisibility.
Mm-hmm. Well, that certainly makes sense. So you're saying it really does help us. We can reboot, if we use that word, reboot our brain by setting these GET statements.
Correct. You know, and the way the reboot the brain came about is that in each of our brains in the back, there's a group of cells called the reticular cells. And it's very small, and it only has one purpose. It's a filter. And so we have, and there's numbers in studies that use different numbers, but the most common is we have about 1 billion bits of information per second coming into our subconscious. So how do we know what to focus on? How to, because if we had all that information, we wouldn't be able to focus.
Mm-hmm.
And so the absolutely. And so the reticular cells synthesizes down the number two, and the numbers also, some are even lower than this, to about 2,000 bits of information. And so the example I use many times is, have you ever purchased a car, driven it off the lot, and all of a sudden you see that same car, that same color, everything is right there. And people say, oh, it's happened to me all the time. And my question then is, were those cars already there? And the answer is yes, we just didn't see
them.
And so programming the reticular cells about what to pay attention to is what's important, and that's the rebooting of the brain.
Well, it's really interesting. I hope people will take time, go to your website and read portions of the book. And it's what I liked was that it's not even as long a book as one might think, because it's a workbook. There's places to write our own GET statements, our vision statements. So it's really an exercise book.
It is. You know, they say knowledge is power, and I don't agree with that. It's the application of the knowledge that makes it powerful.
Well, thank you so much, Gary. I appreciate getting to see you again.
Absolutely.